Hi guys, and welcome to this new video.
Today I want to make another knife from this file. As you can see, it has a pretty nice thickness. I'm gonna use this part of the file because there's already a tang, which is awesome because I don't have to cut one out or to forge one. And the first step will be to cut this part here off. Now I'll forge the bevels. To do this I have to hammer this side here flat, but the other one should keep its thickness like this. As you can see, I put rough bevels on. The next step I will do is to draw the shape of the tip and the whole blade on. And I can cut it out. Let's go to the bench grinder and refine the shape and also the bevels. After this, I'll refine the bevel some more with a file. Time to harden the blade. To do this, you have to heat it up until it's red hot and then quench it in oil. That's how it looks after quenching. Let's make the file test. The file is not able to bite, as you can see. Perfectly fine. Now the blade is very hard, but also very brittle. And to make it a little bit softer, you have to heat it up again, but in a normal cooking oven, and after it should have a golden color. But to see this, I have to sand off the scale a little bit. As I mentioned, I'll put it in the normal cooking oven for 2 hours at 200 degrees Celsius. I don't know if you can see the golden color, but yeah, here you can see it better. Yes, that's after 2.5 hours. Now comes probably the longest part, the sanding. First of all, I'm gonna use some of this rough sand-like stones, and after that I'll move on to some sandpaper. I figured out that this stone here is very, very fine, finer than I thought, and I think I don't need sandpaper after this one. So that's pretty cool. There you can see the finish. The plate is pretty much done, because I'll give it its final sharpness when it's joined with the handle. Because of this, let's make the handle. For the handle, I'll use this wild cherry branch. At the moment my piece has like this size. Now I carve the sides flat. If you have done that, it should look like this. Go ahead and shape your handle like you want it to be. You can cut grooves in tall like this. After a lot of carving, I came to this shape. Before going on and refine the handle with some sandpaper, I want to drill a hole for the tang. Because of this little branch here, I could only drill until here, and because of this I want to heat up the tang. And as you can see, I stuck the blade through a potato to prevent the heat ruining my temper on the blade here, and then I stuck the hot tang into the handle and burned my way through. The wood was dead when I collected it, but I think from the rain it was still a little bit wet, and as you can see it starts to get cracks. Because of this, now I'll try to soak the whole handle in some oil, and hopefully this prevents the wood from cracking.
It's the next day and soaking the wood in oil worked great.
As you can see, there are only just very, very little cracks. You can't even see them, right? And there on this whole surface is no single crack. Now I'll make the handle smooth with some sandpaper. This is the handle after sanding. Time to glue the two pieces together.
the glue dry so I can move on and oil the handle. Last step is to bring the blade to its final sharpness. To do this I will use the 3 redstones. It's a very dry and hard wood. Let's try to carve. Works great.
So guys, I hope you liked this video about this file knife. Thanks for watching and see you.